Ajay was the only son to his parents. Three of them used to work together in the farm. A few days ago, Ajay had lost his parents. Ajay was now all alone in this world.
Since the time my parents have gone away, I feel there is nothing left in my life. I can understand you, Ajay. I feel so lonely. Look after the home or farm, I really can't understand. Anyway, your gas stove was spoiled, right? Did you get it repaired? No, my friend. I don't have enough money to get it repaired. Thinking of making a bonfire for myself.
Ajay makes a bonfire for himself.
I just hope I can manage to cook food on this. Later I'll buy a new stove for myself.
Ajay would often burn his fingers while cooking on bonfire. Sometimes he would feel suffocated due to the smoke. Ajay has to often eat uncooked or burnt food. Once, Ajay returns home very late. There was no food cooked at home. Ajay was extremely hungry. Ajay was sobbing and missing his mother a lot.
Mom, I would have never gone hungry if you would have been alive. I feel so deprived.
Crying, Ajay cooks some porridge. After he finishes eating, he leaves the empty vessel over the bonfire. Next morning,
the porridge that I cooked last night was very tasty. Wish I had saved a bit from that, then I could eat it today too. Why is this cooker so heavy? I had finished all the porridge yesterday itself.
Ajay opens the cooker and sees that it is full with porridge. Ajay is astonished to see this, but he thinks he must have cooked extra porridge last night by mistake. Ajay eats the porridge and also takes some in tiffin to eat while he's at the farm.
Ajay, today you are carrying very tasty tiffin. Looks like you have learned the art of cooking.
That night, Ajay cooks some rotis and vegetable. The vessel he had cooked vegetable is left on the bonfire. After he finishes eating, he removes the vessel from the bonfire. To his surprise, the vessel is again filled to the top with vegetable.
I did not cook so many vegetables today.
Next morning, Ajay prepares some lentils and he distributes the leftover lentils to his neighbors.
Ajay, is this really true? You are distributing food amongst the villagers? Just a few days ago, you didn't have money to repair your gas stove. Shall I tell you a secret? Come with me. Look, this is my magical bonfire. When you cook food on this, the vessel you cook never empties. Food won't get over unless you remove the vessel from the bonfire. This is really very good. But why are you giving food for free to the villagers? You should ask money in exchange of food. Soon you'll be very rich. No, Jay. I don't want to become rich. The bonfire has helped me a lot in my bad time. With the help of this bonfire, even I should do the same. Help the one who is in need. Are you out of your mind? I suggest you should open an eatery. I am your friend Ajay. I am telling you for your good.
Jay and Ajay together opened an eatery. They started earning very well. Jay became greedy as they were earning good money without much efforts. He was thinking how to make this bonfire of his own.
Ajay, did you ever think that if we are earning so much with just one bonfire, then how much will we earn with two? But Jay, there is no guarantee that the new bonfire will also be a magical one. Why don't you make one? Who knows, your magic might work again.
Ajay makes another bonfire. But as soon as he puts wood into the bonfire, it explodes.
How did this happen? What did you put in this while making it? I was making it the way I made the earlier one. Make another one tomorrow.
Ajay makes another bonfire, but even that one explodes. Jay was very angry and he shouted at Ajay.
You can't even make one proper bonfire. Okay, so what? You already have one with you, right? You shouldn't go so mad for money. You are becoming greedy, Ajay. You don't want me to have a magical bonfire. The reason you are making a faulty one.
Ajay just left from there. Ajay was neither greedy nor he wanted to hide his money from Jay. He thought of making a new bonfire again. But this would be the last bonfire. If this one explodes due to fire, then he would give the magical bonfire to Jay and he would go back to his farming. Once again, Ajay made a new bonfire exactly like the one he had made for the first time. He kept it in the eatery and went to sleep.
This Ajay will turn tide on my dreams. If I depend on him, I would never be able to go to the town and earn more money.
Jay sees a bonfire lying in the eatery. He picked it up and took it to his house. Next morning,
Ajay, get up! Get up, Ajay, get up! Get up!
Yes, what happened?
Jay has ran away from the village.
What?
Jay's entire house is empty. He was seen going towards the town with all his belongings. That's what the people were saying. Son, are you not able to bear the shock?
No, uncle. I'm just laughing at Jay's destiny. Why is that? Poor man must have thought that by stealing the magical bonfire, he will be able to earn a lot of money in the town. But last night I took the magical bonfire with me at home, so that I can replicate a new one. Poor Jay took the new bonfire. God knows if there is any magical power in it or not.
Jay opened a shop in town. He puts big hoardings and banners for his eatery's publicity. And very happily, with all the confidence in the world, he starts to prepare a vegetable and lights wood into the bonfire. Like all the earlier bonfires, even this one explodes as soon as it comes in contact with fire. Looking at the bonfire and his luck, Jay has nothing else but to cry. There was a village named Maniganj. The village chief was a very strict man. He wouldn't spare dishonest behavior. There was a utensil seller in the village named Radhishyam.
Dad, mom had asked for a pot to hit on her head.
No, not my head, but his head, Dad.
I gave you a pot just the other day. You need one more? Well, take this one.
Radhishyam had two children, Bablu and Chinky. Since the shop was right next door to their house, they turned up at the shop all the time.
Dad, mom has asked for a set of tongs to beat up Bablu.
No, Dad, but it is to squeeze Chinky's nose.
I think your mother will empty the entire shop. You took a pot yesterday. Today you want tongs. If you're going to use everything at home, what will I sell to my customers? Here, take the tong.
And Dad, mom has also asked you to bring 1 kilo jalebis when you come home. If you don't bring the jalebis, remember that mom has new tongs.
Are you going or not? You're just becoming like your mother day by day.
Radhishyam's shop was always busy. He was leading a happy life with his wife and his kids. However, Bhagwan Das had an eye on his happy life. Bhagwan Das and his family were new to this village. He was thinking about starting a new business.
There are at least 4 to 5 sweet shops in this village. There are quite a few convenience stores too. But there is only one utensil shop. I think I should open a utensil shop.
Bhagwan Das opened his utensil stores, but he had no customers. Everyone still went to Radhishyam's shop.
Dhanteras is approaching soon, and I haven't sold even one utensil yet. I have to do something about Radhishyam's business first. I'll make such a sinister plan that he will want to leave the village.
Late at night, when Radhishyam was shutting his shop, Bhagwan Das approached him wearing a disguise.
Hey Sonu, Radhe Shyam lives in my neighboring village. I have heard a lot about your shop. My daughter is getting married. I need a lot of big brass pots. Why not show?
Bhagwan Das bought the pots from Radhe Shyam and he took them home. He created cheap and bad quality replicas of Radhe Shyam's pots with steel and he polished them to make it look like brass. 2 days later, he took the vessels back to Radhe Shyam's shop.
Hey Sonu, my in-laws did not like the vessels. I am sorry. I would like to return these and please give me my money back. You know very well how expensive a daughter's wedding can be.
Radhe Shyam took the vessels back and he returned customers' money. He did not realize that he was in possession of fake vessels. By the time Dhanteras came, all of Radhe Shyam's brass vessels got sold. Some days later, the fake polish had faded.
This is steel. That Radhe Shyam has cheated us.
The villagers complained about Radhe Shyam to the village chief.
Radhe Shyam, you know the rules of this village. If in case a shopkeeper tries to cheat with the customers, then he has to leave the village. Now you cannot live in this village. You will have to pay 50,000 rupees as fine.
Radhe Shyam somehow managed to sell his remaining vessels and his house to pay off the fine. He took his family and left the village.
Dad, where will we go now?
I don't know, love. I don't even know a relative who lives nearby. What have you carried in this bag?
Some rice and a pot that I saved for us so that we can eat food on the way somewhere. Radhe Shyam's family walked all day. When the sun started to set, they rested under a tree.
Kids, we have to stay positive even during the tough times. Difficulties are also part of life. Consider this a small vacation until we can find a good shelter somewhere.
Radhe Shyam's wife begins to cook rice. An old man approaches them.
My son, my wife and I are hungry since 5 days. Please give me some rice from your pot or else my wife will die.
Baba, we have nothing to give you.
I think this old man is hungrier than us. We should give him some of our share.
But what will our kids eat?
I'll go to the jungle tomorrow and find something to eat. Trust the Lord. The man needs the rice more than we do. And it is our duty to help those in need.
Radhe Shyam gives the old man both the rice and the pot. That night, Radhe Shyam's family went to sleep hungry. As soon as they woke up in the morning, Bablu and Chinky started to cry.
We are very hungry. Is there anything to eat?
Radhe Shyam goes to the jungle to find something to eat. He encounters the same old man from the previous night.
Last night itself, a 20-year-old lost son came back to us. You helped us yesterday. And in return, I would like to give you this pressure cooker as a gift.
Before Radhe Shyam could say anything, the old man vanished.
Where did this old man go giving me this cooker? What am I going to do with this empty cooker? Rather, he should have given me some actual food.
In the jungle, Radhe Shyam came across some lotus flowers in a pond. He picks some lotus stems and takes it back to the family.
I couldn't find anything other than these lotus stems.
And where did you find this cooker?
The old man who came last night to us, he gave me this cooker. Boil the lotus stems in the cooker, then we can eat.
After some whistles of the cooker that went off, when Radhe Shyam's wife opened the cooker, she was shocked to see that the lotus stems had turned to gold.
How is that possible?
Radhe Shyam tried to boil other things in the cooker. Whatever he put in there turned to gold. Radhe Shyam's family goes to a neighboring village and settles down there. With the help of the magical cooker, Radhe Shyam opens his own jewelry store. In Maniganj, the story of the magical cooker spread around. Radhe Shyam was our neighbor, right? I've heard he is very successful now, but he still helps those in need. Bhagwan Das finds out about Radhe Shyam. The next day, he goes to his jewelry shop.
I have heard a lot about you. My wife is very ill. If she doesn't get a treatment, she will die. I am taking her to the city for the medical treatment. Please give me your gold-giving cooker just for one day. Once the treatment is done, I will bring it back to you.
Radhe Shyam trusts Bhagwan Das and gives him the cooker. Bhagwan Das runs back to the village with the cooker in hand.
Radhe Shyam is so stupid. I tricked him so easily and took his cooker. Now I will boil some potatoes in it. Potatoes will turn into gold.
Bhagwan Das puts potatoes in the cooker and puts it on the stove and waits for the stove to go off.
Come on, whistle, come on.
The cooker's whistle doesn't go off, but instead it blasts. Bhagwan Das turns black because of the blast and he starts crying.
Oh, what happened?
The saying is true. Whoever has ill intentions will get a black face.